Okay. I want to thank the contest. It was very good. I wish I could understand the words, but the tune, I'm sure it was very good to me. If there is one doctrine above any other doctrine,
iznad svih ostalih doktrina,
produce fear in God's people,
koja u Božem narodu izaziva strah,
it is the judgment.
Onda je to sud, doktrina o sudu.
People are afraid of the judgment.
Ljudi se boje suda.
There was a time when I was afraid.
Nekada sam se ja bojao.
I would say to Jesus,
govorio sam Isusu,
please don't bring my name as yet.
Nemoj još da iznosiš moje ime.
I'm not good enough.
Još nisam dovoljno dobar.
Well, I've discovered that you will never be good enough.
A onda sam otkrio da nećemo nikad biti dovoljno dobri.
The doctrine of judgment,
doktrina o sudu,
is good news.
Je radosna vest.
It is part of the good news of the gospel.
Ona je deo radosne vesti evanđelja.
But only to those who are resting 100% in Christ's righteousness.
Ali samo za one koji 100% počivaju u Hristovoj pravilnosti.
And have lost all confidence in their righteousness.
I koji su izgubili svako pouzdanje u svoju sopstvenu pravilnost.
But to the legalist, the judgment is bad news.
Ali za legaliste sud je loša vest.
Because when you give all the list of good things you have done,
jer kada date sam spisak svih dobrih dela koje ste učinili,
Jesus will say, I don't know you.
Isus će reći, ne poznajem te.
But to those who are resting in him,
ali onima koji počivaju u njemu,
he will vindicate us.
On će ih obraniti.
Let me give you the text that has produced fear.
Da navedemo tekst koji je izazvao strah.
Daniel chapter 7.
Danilo 7. poglavlje.
Verse 9 and 10.
Stihovi 9 i 10. Danilo 7.
9 and 10.
9 i 10.
I watched till thrones were put in place.
Gledah dokle se postaviše prestoli.
And the Ancient of Days was seated.
I starac, i starešina dana sede.
His garment was white as snow.
Na tom beše odelo belo kao sneg.
And the hair of his head was like pure wool.
I kosa na glavi kao čista vuna.
His throne was a fiery flame.
Presto mu beše kao plamen ognjeni.
Its wheels a burning fire.
Točkovi mu kao ogen razgoreo.
A fire stream issued and came forth from before him.
Reka ognjena izlažaše i tecijaše ispred njega.
Thousands ministered to him.
Tisuća služaše mu.
These are angels.
To su anđeli.
10,000 times 10,000 stood before him.
I 10,000 po 10,000 stajalo pred njim.
That is us.
To smo mi.
The court was seated.
Sud sede.
And the books were open.
I knjige se otvoriše.
And the knees of the believers began to knock.
I kolena vernika su počela da se trese.
That is my vision.
To sam ja dodao.
Very frightening passage.
Vrlo strašan tekst.
But this passage,
ali ovaj tekst,
is dealing with the trial, the investigation.
Govori o suđenju, o istraživanju.
Now let's look at the verdict.
A sada gledamo kakva je presuda.
Verse 22.
22. stih.
Until the Ancient of Days came,
dokle dođe starac,
and a judgment was made in favor of the saints of the Most High.
I dade se sud u korist svetaca višnjega. Ovdje kaže sud svetaca.
What does that? It was like
the judgment is.
Tu se
procesi. Yes. But the word tu means in favor.
Da.
In Hebrew, that is what it means.
Jeste.
The judgment was made in favor of the saints.
Dakle, sud je bio u korist svetaca.
And then the time came for the saints to possess the kingdom.
I prispe vreme da sveci preuzmu carstvo.
Now the first thing that we need to know about the judgment.
Prva stvar koju treba da znamo o sudu
is that all three members of the Godhead are on our side.
Jeste da su sve tri ličnosti božanstva na našoj strani.
All three.
Sve tri ličnosti.
Please turn to Romans chapter 8. I can give you many texts, but here's a good one that gives all three.
Pogledajmo Rimljanima poslanicu 8. poglavlje.
In chapter 8 of Romans.
U 8. poglavlju Rimljanima poslanicu.
Verse 16 and 17.
16. i 17. stih.
I read this. The Spirit himself bears witness with our spirit that we are children of God.
Ovaj duh svedoči našemu duhu da smo deca Božja.
And if children, then heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ, if indeed we suffer with him, that we may also be glorified with him.
A kad smo deca i nasljednici smo, nasljednici dakle Božji, a sunasljednici Hristovi, jer s njim stradamo, da se s njim i proslavimo.
So the Holy Spirit is on our side.
Dakle, Sveti Duh je na našoj strani.
Then look at verse 31.
A onda pogledajmo 31. stih.
Same chapter.
Isto poglavlje.
What then shall we say to these things?
Šta ćemo dakle reći na ovo?
If God is for us, who can be against us?
Ako je Bog s nama, ko će na nas, to jest ko će biti protiv nas?
What Paul is saying here, if God is on our side, it doesn't matter who is against you.
Drugim rečima, Pavle hoće da kaže, ako je Bog na našoj strani, nije važno ko će biti protiv nas.
How do we know God is on our side?
Kako znamo da je Bog na našoj strani?
Look at verse 32.
Pogledajmo 32. stih.
He who did not spare his own son.
Koji dakle svoga sina ne poštede.
The he is God the Father.
Koji je Bog Otac.
In Gethsemane, Jesus said, please, Father, if possible, remove the cup.
U Getsemani je Bog, Isus kazao, molim te, Oče, ako je moguće, ukloni ovu čašu.
And the Father said, no.
A Otac je kazao,
he spared not his own son.
Dakle, sina svoga nije poštedao.
But delivered him up for us all.
Nego da predade za sve nas.
And he did that while we were still sinners.
I to je učinio još dok smo bili grešnici.
How shall he not with him also freely give us all things?
Kako dakle da nam s njim sve ne daruje?
Who shall bring a charge against God's elect?
Ko će optužiti izbrane Božije?
The Father will never accuse you.
Otac nas neće nikada optužiti.
The reason, it is God who justifies.
A razlog za to jeste Bog koji pravda.
Then in verse 34.
A onda 34.
Who is he who condemns?
Ko će osuditi?
It is Christ who died.
Hristos Isus koji umre.
He died to remove that condemnation.
On je umro da bi uklonio tu osudu.
Who is even at the right hand of God, who also makes intercession for us.
Pa još i vaskrse koji je s desne strane Bogu i moli za nas.
If God is on our side,
ako je Bog na našoj strani,
and Paul tells us in Timothy,
a Paul nam kaže u Timotiju poslanicu,
that God knows them that are his,
da Bog poznaje svoje,
why a judgment?
Zašto onda postoji sud?
So there are some Christians who say believers will not have to stand before the judgment seat of God.
Neki vernici kažu da oni koji su verni Bogu neće morati da stoje na sudu.
Because they are already justified.
Jer su već opravdani.
But that is not biblical.
Ali to nije biblijski.
Let me give you some text.
Da navedemo neki tekst.
Romans 14.
Rimljanima 14. poglavlje.
Look at Romans 14.
Dakle, Rimljanima 14.
Verse 10.
10. stih.
Paul is writing to Christians.
Pavle piše hrišćanima.
And he says.
I kaže.
But why do you judge your brother? Or why do you show contempt for your brother? For we, that we believers, shall all stand before the judgment seat of Christ.
A ti zašto osuđuješ brata svojega? Ili ti zašto ukoravaš brata svojega? Jer ćemo svi mi, to jest vrednici, izići na sud pred Hrista.
Then turn to 2 Corinthians chapter 5.
Pronađemo sada 2 Korinćanima 5. poglavlje.
And again, Paul is addressing Christians.
Pavle se obraća hrišćanima.
And in verse 10,
i u 10. stihu,
we read,
čitamo,
for we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ.
Jer nam se svima valje javiti na sudu Hristovu.
That each one may receive the things done in the body, according to what he has done, whether good or bad.
Da primimo svaki što koji je u telu činio, ili dobro ili zlo.
And 1 Peter 4:17 says,
a 1 Petrova 4:17 kaže,
that judgment begins at the house of God.
Da će sud početi od kuće Božije.
Why should God judge us?
Zašto bi nam Bog sudio?
When he has already declared us righteous in Christ.
Ako nas je već proglasio pravednima u Hristu.
The only reason.
Jedini razlog.
We ever go to court.
Što ćemo ikada otići na sud?
Is because somebody is accusing you.
Zato što nas neko optužuje.
You know, I have been to court only once.
Ja sam na sudu bio samo jednom.
I had an appointment.
Imao sam zakazan sastanak.
And I was going a bit too fast to meet my appointment.
I išao sam suviše brzo da bih stigao na taj sastanak.
And a policeman stopped me.
I onda me jedan policajac zaustavio.
Gave me a ticket.
Dao mi je priznanicu.
For overspeeding.
Za preveliku prekoračenje brzine.
And I said to myself,
a onda sam kazao sebi,
I need to see what the court is like in America.
Treba da vidim kako izgleda sud u Americi.
So I went to court.
I tako sam otišao na sud.
And my name came up.
Došlo je na red moje ime.
And I explained to the judge.
Objasnio sam sudi
that I had a very important appointment. I was late, so I was going fast.
Da sam imao važan sastanak, kasnio sam, pa sam zato išao brzo.
I said to him, I've been in this country 13 years.
U ovoj zemlji sam već 30 godina.
And this is the first time
I have 13
years. And this is the first time I've been caught for overspeeding.
I prvi puta su me uhvatili za prekoračenje brzine.
And you must agree, I said to the judge, you must agree.
I morate se složiti, kazao sam sudi.
This is not bad for a pastor.
Da to nije nešto loše za pastora.
And he said to me,
a on mi je kazao,
are you sure this is the first time?
Jeste li sigurni da je ovo prvi put?
You've been caught speeding.
Da ste uhvaćeni za prekoračenje.
I said, you can check the records.
Rekao sam mu, pa možete provjeriti dosije.
So he said to me,
i onda mi je odkazao,
are you expecting grace from me?
Da li vi od mene očekujete milost?
I said, yes.
Kazao sam da.
Okay, he said, you may go.
U redu, kazao je, možete.
I said, thank you.
Kazao sam mu hvala.
Now, is there anyone accusing us Christians?
Postoji li neko ko optužuje nas hrišćane?
According to the Bible.
Prema Bibliji.
Is anyone accusing us?
Ima li nekoga ko nas optužuje?
Who's that?
Ko je to?
The devil.
Đavo.
How often is he accusing you all?
Koliko nas često optužuje?
day and night.
Dan i noć.
Look at Revelation 12.
Pogledajmo 12. poglavlje Otkrivenja Jovanovog.
Chapter 12 of Revelation.
12. poglavlje Otkrivenja.
Verse 10.
10. stih.
Then I heard a loud voice saying in heaven.
I čuo glas veliki na nebu koji govori.
Now salvation and strength and the kingdom of our God and the power of his Christ has come.
Sad posta spasenje i sila i carstvo Boga našega i oblast Hrista njegova.
This is referring to the cross.
To se odnosi na krst.
Then goes for the accuser of our brethren who accuses them before our God day and night has been cast down.
A onda kaže, jer se zbavci opadač braće naše koji ih opadaše pred Bogom našim dan i noć.
How can he accuse us day and night?
Kako nas on može optuživati dan i noć?
You mean we are still sinners while we are sleeping?
Zar smo mi grešnici kad spavamo?
Yes.
Da.
Even when we are sleeping, we are sinners.
I kad spavamo, mi smo grešnici.
And so before Christ can come to take us to heaven,
i zato pre nego što Isus može da dođe da nas uzme na nebo,
he has to shut the mouth of the accuser.
On mora da zatvori usta optuživaču.
That is the purpose of the judgment.
To je svrha suda.
It is not to find out whether you are good enough to be saved.
Svrha suda nije da bi se saznalo da li smo dovoljno dobri da bismo bili spašeni.
The purpose of the judgment is for the judge to say to Satan, you have no claim on these people, they are mine.
Svrha suda je da Bog kaže Sotoni, ne možeš da polažeš pravo na one ljude, oni su moji.
How does Jesus our advocate do it?
Kako Isus, naš advokat, to čini?
Before I can answer that question,
pred nego što odgovorim na to pitanje,
I must present you a problem.
Moram da vam iznesem problem.
A real problem.
Pravi problem.
In the Bible, the New Testament,
u Bibliji, u Novom Zavetu,
there are two groups of texts.
Postoje dve grupe tekstova,
which on the surface seems to contradict each other.
Koje površno gledano izgledaju kao da su u suprotnosti jedni sa drugima.
One group of text says,
jedna grupa tekstova kaže,
that we are justified,
da smo opravdani,
we are declared righteous,
da smo proglašeni pravednima,
by faith,
verom,
apart from any good works,
bez ikakvih dobrih dela,
apart from any law keeping.
Bez ikakvog držanja zakona.
That is one group of text.
To je jedna grupa teksta.
Another group of text says,
druga grupa tekstova kaže,
we are judged,
da će nam se suditi,
and rewarded,
i da ćemo biti nagrađeni,
according to our works,
prema našim delima.
Let me give you some text of this to both this group.
Da pročitamo neke tekstove iz ove grupe.
Turn to Romans chapter 3. I'm giving you now the text that say we are justified by faith without works or law keeping.
Dakle, sada navodimo tekstove koji kažu da ćemo se opravdati bez držanja zakona.
Romans chapter 3.
Rimljanima 3. poglavlje.
Verse 28.
25. stih.
Please notice what Paul says there.
Pazimo što kaže Pavlo.
Therefore, we conclude that a person, a man is justified by faith apart from the deeds of the law.
3:28. Not 28. 3:28. Mislimo dakle da će se čovjek opravdati verom bez dela zakona. 28. stih.
Very clear text. the justified by faith without any law.
Veoma jasan tekst. Dakle, opravdavamo se verom bez držanja zakona.
Then in chapter 4.
A onda u četvrtom poglavlju.
Of the same book.
Iste poslije.
Verse 5.
Peti stih.
But to him who does not work, but believes on him who justifies the ungodly, his faith is accounted for righteousness.
A onome koji ne radi, a veruje onoga koji pravda bezbožnika, prima se vera njegova u pravdu.
Very clear. We have done no good works.
Veoma jasno.
We believe in Jesus Christ.
Nismo uradili nikakva dobra dela, verujemo u
Krista. And he declares us righteous.
I on nas proglašava pravednim.
Then go to Ephesians chapter 2.
Pređimo sada na Efesima drugog
poglavlja. I've already given you this text before, I'm just showing you.
Već sam vam ranije čitao taj tekst, ali sada samo pokazujem.
Chapter 2 of Ephesians.
Drugo poglavlje.
Verse 8 and 9.
8 i 9 stih.
For by grace you have been saved, through faith, and that not of yourself, it is the gift of God.
Jer ste blagodaću spaseni kroz veru, i to nije od vas, dar je Boži.
And it refers to grace, to salvation, is a gift of God.
Dakle, spasenje je dar od Boga.
Then in verse 9, not of works, lest anyone should boast.
A onda u 9. stihu kaže, ne od dela, da se niko ne pohvali.
So these are clear statements.
Ovo su vrlo jasne izjave.
That we are saved apart from law keeping, apart from good works.
Da se spasavamo odvojeno od držanja zakona.
But then there is another group of texts.
Ali postoji druga grupa tekstova.
We say that we are judged and rewarded according to our works.
Gde se kaže da će nam se suditi i da ćemo biti nagrađeni prema našim delima.
Let me give you some of them too.
Pročitajmo sada neke od njih.
John, the Gospel of John.
Evanđelje po Jovanu.
Chapter 5.
Peto poglavlje.
Verse 28 and 29.
28 i 29 stih.
And this is Jesus talking.
To govori Isus.
Verse 28.
28 stih.
Do not marvel at this, for the hour is coming when in which all who are in the grave will hear his voice.
Ne divite se ovome, jer ide čas u koji će svi koji su u grobovima čuti glas Sina Božjega.
And come forth those who have done good to the resurrection of life, and those who have done evil to the resurrection of condemnation.
Izići će koji su činili dobro u vaskrsenje života, a koji su činili zlo u vaskrsenje suda.
Doesn't that sound like salvation by works?
Zar ovo ne zvuči kao spasenje delima?
2 Corinthians chapter 5 and verse 10, which we have already read, says the same thing.
Druga Korinčanima, peto poglavlje.
We will be rewarded according to our works.
Dakle, bit ćemo nagrađeni prema
delima. Yeah, we read already.
Već smo to čitali.
Matthew 16:27.
Sorry, 2 Corinthians 5.
10. Yeah, we read it already.
Druga Korinčanima 5:10, već smo čitali.
Yeah. Matthew 16:27.
Matin 16:27.
Says the same thing. You want to, you can take it down and read at home.
Možete zapisati pa pročitati kod kuće.
Let me read you one more text.
Da pročitamo još jedan tekst.
Revelation.
Otkrivenje.
22.
22.
The last book of the Bible.
Posljednja knjiga Biblije.
And chapter 22.
22. poglavlje.
The last chapter of the Bible too.
Također posljednje poglavlje Biblije.
Verse 12.
12. stih.
And behold, I am coming quickly.
I evo ću doći skoro.
And my reward is with me.
I plata moja sa mnom.
To give to everyone according to his work.
Da dam svakome po delima njegovim.
And these two group of texts seem to contradict each other.
Ove dve grupe tekstova, dakle, izgleda kao da su u suprotnosti.
So what do Christians do?
Šta onda hrišćani rade?
They choose the group they like.
izaberu grupu tekstova koja im se sviđa.
So some choose the one that say we are say justified by faith without works, without law keeping.
Dakle, jedni bili one tekstove koji kažu da se spašavamo samo verom, bez dela, bez držanja zakona.
And others say, prefer the other group to say, ah, we better be good because we'll be judged and rewarded according to our works.
A druga grupa bira one druge tekstove i kaže, bolje bi ti bilo da budeš dobar jer ćemo, jer će nam se suditi i dobit ćemo nagradu prema svojim delima.
You cannot do that.
Ne možemo tako raditi.
Both groups are inspired.
Ove grupe tekstova su nadahnute.
Both groups are written by some, very often by the same individuals.
Vrlo često ove grupe tekstova su pisale pisali isti pisci.
So the question is, how do we reconcile these two groups together?
Postavlja se pitanje sada kako da pomirimo ove dve grupe tekstova.
Which seems to contradict the truth.
Koje su naizgled u suprotnosti.
There is a third group that joins them together.
Postoji treća grupa tekstova koja ih spaja.
And it goes something like this.
I otprilike u toj grupi tekstova se kaže ovako.
Genuine justification by faith.
Iskreno opravdanje verom
always produces works.
Uvek donosi dela.
The works don't save us.
Dela nas ne spasavaju.
But they are the evidence of our salvation.
Ali su ona dokaz našeg spasenja.
Let me give you some text on this too.
Da pogledamo neke tekstove ovdje.
We'll start with Jesus.
Počet ćemo sa Isusom.
John 14.
Evanđelje po Jovanu 14. stih.
John 14.
Jovan 14.
One of the apostles, one of the disciples.
Jedan od učenika.
Comes to Jesus.
Dolazi Isusu.
And you'll find this in verse 8.
Pronaći ćete o tome u 8. stihu.
Philip said to him, to Jesus.
Reče mu Filip, Isusu.
Lord, show us the Father and it is sufficient for us.
Gospode, pokaži nam Oca i bit će nam dosta.
We have seen you, Jesus, but we want to see God.
Mi smo vidjeli tebe, Isuse, ali mi želimo da vidimo Boga.
Listen to the answer Jesus gave.
Poslušajmo odgovor koji je Isus dao.
Jesus said to him,
Isus mu reče,
have I been with you so long? And yet you have not known me, Philip.
Toliko sam vreme s vama i nisi me poznao, Filipe.
He who has seen me has seen the Father. So how can you say, show us the Father?
Koji vide mene, vide Oca. Pa kako ti govoriš, pokaži nam Oca.
Do you not believe that I am in the Father and the Father in me? The words that I speak to you, I do not speak on my own authority, but the Father who dwells in me, He does the works.
Zar ne veruješ da sam ja u Ocu i Otac u meni? Reči koje vam ja govorim, ne govorim od sebe, svojim autoritetom, nego Otac koji stoji u meni, On tvori dela.
Verse 11.
I 11. stih.
Believe me that I am in the Father and the Father in me. Or else, believe me for the sake of the works themselves.
Verujte meni da sam ja u Ocu i Otac u meni. Ako i meni ne verujete, verujte mi po tim delima.
What evidence did Christ give that the Father was working through him?
Koji dokaz je Isus dao da je Otac delovao kroz njega.
It was his works.
To su bila njegova dela.
And now look at verse 12.
Sada pogledajmo 12. stih.
Most assuredly I say to you.
Zaista, zaista vam kažem.
He who believes in me, the works that I do, he will do also. And greater works than these he will do because I go to my Father.
Koji veruje mene, dela koje ja tvorim i on će tvoriti.
What
I neće će od ovih tvoriti, jer ja idem k Ocu svojem.
What did he mean?
Šta je on mislio?
Do you remember a passage in John?
Sjećate li se teksta iz Jovana?
Where Jesus said,
gdje je Isus kazao,
abide in me,
živite u meni,
and I in you.
Budite u meni i ja ću biti u vama.
Without me,
bez mene,
you can do nothing.
Ne možete činiti ništa.
But if you abide in me,
ali ako ste u meni,
I in you,
i ja u vama,
you will do much works.
Činit ćete mnoga dela.
And my father will be pleased.
I to će biti po volji oca mojega.
It is in the next chapter of John, chapter 15.
To je u sljedećem poglavlju u 15.
Verse 4 onwards.
Od 4. Stiha i nadalje.
In Matthew 5.
U Mateju
I want you to look at it in Matthew 5.
Da pogledamo to Matej, peto poglavlje.
Jesus said two things.
Isus je kazao dve stvari.
About believers.
O vjernicima.
In verse 13.
U 13. Stihu.
He tells us.
On nam kaže.
That we are the salt of the earth.
Da smo so zemlji.
Please look at chapter 5 verse 13.
Pogledajmo peto poglavlje, 13. Stih.
You are the salt of the earth.
Vi ste sol zemlje.
But if the salt loses its flavor, how shall it be seasoned?
Ali ako sol obljutavi ili izgubi svoj ukus, čim će se osoliti?
It is then good for nothing but to be trodden out and trampled underfoot by man.
Ona već neće biti ni za što, osim da se prospe napolje i da je ljudi poraze.
Now Jesus made this statement.
Isus je dao ovu izjavu.
By the Sea of Galilee.
Kraj Galilejskog mora.
His listeners.
Njegovi slušalci.
Were mainly fishermen.
Su uglavnom bili ribari.
They caught fish.
Hvatali su ribu.
But the best market was in Jerusalem.
Ali najbolje tržište bilo je u Jerusalimu.
60 miles away.
60 milja odatle.
There was no ice in those days.
U te dane nije bilo leda.
No aeroplanes.
Nije bilo aviona.
No trains.
Nije bilo vozila.
No cars.
Nije bilo kola.
They carried the fish on the back of donkeys.
Prevozili su ribu na leđima magaraca.
60 miles.
60 milja.
How many kilometers that is?
Znate li koliko je to?
100 kilometers.
Oko 100 kilometara.
How many days does it take a donkey to walk 100 kilometers?
Koliko je dana potrebno da magarac pređe 100 kilometara?
2 days, 2-3 days?
2-3 dana.
What will happen to the fish in 3 days?
Šta će se dogoditi sa ribom za 3 dana?
Rotten.
Pokvarit će se.
So what did they do?
I šta su oni činili?
They rubbed the fish with salt.
Utrljavali su sol.
And salt acted as a retardant.
I sol je delovala da usporava trunjenje.
And what Christ is saying,
ono što je Hristos želeo da kaže,
that the world is rotting because of sin.
Jeste da se greh kvari zbog greha.
And we Christians,
a mi hrišćani,
as we rubbed the world,
koji smo utrljati u svet,
we must retard the rotting process.
Moramo da zaustavimo proces truljenja, raspadanja.
One day,
jednoga dana,
when we were in Ethiopia,
dok smo bili u Etiopiji,
and it had gone communist,
prošli su.
Yeah, Ethiopia had become communist. They rationed the benzene. How much benzene you can have? 10 liters for 1 week.
Oni su određivali koliko može da se kupi benzina. 10 liters.
Per week.
10 litera nedelje.
That was the ration.
To je bio racionalizacija.
And you had to go to the government.
Trebalo je da odete u
to get that card.
Da dobijete kartu.
So I went to the government.
Ja sam otišao tamo.
And the government officer said to me.
I vladin činovnik mi je kazao.
What work do you do?
Čime se baviš?
I said, I'm a minister.
Kazao sam, ja sam propovednik.
And he thought I was a minister of the government.
Da, najčešće se kaže službenik, a on je mislio da sam ja vladin službenik.
So he gave me 300 liters.
On mi je dao 300 litara.
And I did not complain.
A ja se nisam žalio.
But I was teaching at the college.
A ja sam predavao na koleđu.
And we could get benzene only in Addis Ababa, 150 kilometers away.
Mogli smo da kupimo benzin samo u Addis Abebi oko 150 kilometara.
So I had a big barrel on top of my car.
Pa zato na krovu svojih kola ima jedno veliko bure.
That took 300 liters.
U koje je moglo da stane 300 litera.
And when it was low, I would come back to Addis Ababa to fill it up again.
I kad bi nivo ulja benzina pao, išao sam u Addis Abebu da ga ponovo napunim.
And of course, all my friends said, can you give me some? All my friends.
Svim prijateljima svojim mogao sam da dam pomalo.
But one day, as I was coming to Addis to put some, to get some more benzene.
Jednog dana, kad sam išao da kupim još benzina,
two young men,
dva mladića,
stopped me.
Su me zaustavili.
About 3 kilometers from the city.
Negde oko 3 kilometara pre grada.
And I thought their car was broken down.
Pomislio sam da su im kola ukvarila.
And since I know a little bit of mechanics, I stopped to help them.
Pošto se malo razumem u mehaniku, zaustavio sam se da bih im pomogao.
And they said to me,
oni su mi kazali,
our car is not broken down.
Naša kola nisu u kvaru.
We have run out of benzine.
Nestao nam je benzin.
Can you give us a little bit?
Možete li nam dati malo?
My barrel was empty.
Bure mi je bilo prazno.
I had some in my tank in the car.
U rezervaru sam imao nešto.
And I said, if I give you some of my benzine, I might run out before I reach the city.
Ako vam dam nešto benzina, možda će meni nestati pre nego što dođem do grada.
So one of the young men said to me,
tako je jedan od mladića mi kazao,
come and see.
Dođite da vidite.
They had a pickup, a small truck.
Oni su imali mali kamiončić.
They took me to the pickup.
Odveli su me do njega.
It was filled with fish.
Bio je pun ribe.
They were taking it to the hotel.
Vozili su je u jedan hotel.
A very big hotel.
Veliki hotel.
And they said to me, if we wait too long, this fish will get rotten and we will lose all the money.
Ako čekamo dugo, sva riba će se pokvariti i izgubit ćemo dosta novaca.
So I said to them,
i onda sam im ja kazao,
how long have you been waiting?
Koliko dugo čekate?
2 hours.
2 sata već.
And nobody has helped you?
I niko vam nije pomogao.
They said, no, nobody stopped to help us.
Ne, niko nije stao da nam pomogne.
So I said, I will take the risk, I'll give you some.
I onda sam ja kazao, rizikovat ću, dat ću vam malo
pomogne. So I siphoned some from my car and gave it to them.
Da, izvadio sam nešto iz svog rezervoara i dao sam.
And the young man said to me,
mladić mi je kazao,
this is communism.
Ovo je komunizam.
I said, no.
A rekao sam, ne.
Those 2 hours was communism.
Ona 2 sata su bila komunizam.
This is Christianity.
Ovo je kršćanstvo.
In communism, no one gives you from the heart, only by God.
U komunizmu vam niko ne daje od srca, samo ako je ispred puške.
So Christianity produces works.
Dakle, hrišćanstvo proizvodi dela.
And the Bible is clear. I gave you some from now look at verse 14 of Matthew 5.
I Biblija je jasna. Pogledajmo još neke tekstove iz Marka.
Matthew 5, verse 14.
14. stih, 5:14.
You are the light of the world. The city that is set on a hill cannot be hidden.
Vi ste videlo svetu. Ne može se grad sakriti kad na gori stoji.
So we are two things.
Dakle, mi smo dve stvari.
We are salt.
Mi smo sol.
And our job is negative to retard the rotting process of the world.
I naš posao je negativan da zaustavimo kvarenje sveta.
But we are also positive. We are the light of the world.
Ali i smo i pozitivni jer smo svetlost svetu.
Now I don't know how it is in your Yugoslavian Bible, but in the original.
Ne znam kako je u vašoj Bibliji, ali u originalu.
The you is in the plural.
Vi je u množini. Yes.
Okay. The word light is in the singular.
Reč svetlo je u jednini.
Yours too?
Yes.
So we are many.
Nas je mnogo.
Only one light.
Ali samo je jedno videlo.
Who is the light of the world?
Ko je videlo svetu?
Jesus Christ.
Isus Hristos.
And what Jesus is saying, the world needs to see me in you.
A ono što Isus kaže jeste svet treba da vidi mene kroz vas.
In other words, Christ in you, the hope of glory.
Drugim rečima, Hristos u vama nada slave.
Now look at verse 16.
Pogledajmo sada 16. stih.
Let your light shine before men.
Tako da se svetli vaše videlo pred ljudima.
When you have light, you don't put it under a bushel. You put it up so that it can light everybody.
Kada imamo svetlo, ne stavljamo ga pod nešto da ga zaklonimo, nego ga iznosimo da svetli svima.
So it says, let your light so shine before men.
Dakle, kaže ovde, tako da se svetli vaše videlo pred ljudima.
That they may see your good works.
Da vide vaša dobra dela.
And glorify your denomination.
I slave vašu denominaciju.
Yes?
Vašu crkvu.
No.
Da.
Glorify you.
Da slave vas.
No.
Ne.
What does it say?
Šta kaže?
Glorify your Father in heaven.
Da slave Otca vašega koji je na nebesu.
Because the works come from God.
Jer dela dolaze od Boga.
Now let's go to Ephesians.
Pređimo sada na Efescima.
Chapter 2.
Drugo poglavlje.
We read verse 8 and 9.
Čitali smo
which tells us,
8. i 9. stih koji nam kažu,
which tells us that we are saved by grace through faith and not of works.
Da nam se kaže da smo spašeni blagodaću kroz veru, a ne od dela.
And look at verse 10.
Ali pogledajmo 10. stih.
For we are his workmanship created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared beforehand that we should walk in them.
Jer smo njegov posao sazdani u Hristu Isusu za dela dobra koja Bog napred pripravi da u njima hodimo.
So Jesus did not only save us from condemnation to justification.
Dakle, Isus nas nije samo spasio od osude i opravdao nas,
but he also saved us for a life of good works.
Nego nas je također spasio za život
dobrih dela. Now I want to make it very clear.
Želim da to bude veoma jasno.
You may not be aware of those good works.
Vi možda nećete biti svesni tih dobrih dela.
Because Jesus will say to you in the judgment.
Jer će vam Isus na sudu kazati.
I was hungry.
Bio sam gladan.
You fed me.
Nahranio si me.
I was naked.
Bio sam gol.
You clothed me.
Odenuo si me.
I was in prison.
Bio sam u zatvoru.
You visited me.
Obišao si me.
What will the believers say?
Šta će vernici kazati?
Yes, Jesus, we kept a record every week.
Da, Isuse, mi smo obeležili svake sedmice šta smo radili.
No, what the believers say?
Ne, šta će reći vernici?
When did we do this thing?
Kad smo uradili?
So you may not be aware.
Možda nećemo biti svesni toga.
Because what you're doing is spontaneous.
Jer ono što radimo, radimo spontano.
Let me give one more text.
Da navedem još jedan text.
Titus chapter 3.
Titus, treće poglavlje.
Look at verse 5.
Peti stih.
This is the gospel.
Ovo je evanđelje.
Titus 3, which is after 2 Timothy, And verse 5.
Titu posle druge Timotiju treće poglavlje 15.
Not by works of righteousness which we have done, but according to his mercy he saved us.
Ne za delo pravedna koja mi učinismo, nego po svojoj milosti spase nas.
Through the washing of regeneration and renewing of the Holy Spirit.
Banom prerođenja i obnovljenjem Duha Svetog.
So we are saved because of God's mercy and his work in Christ.
Dakle, mi smo spašeni milošću i kroz ono što je Hristos učinio.
Now look at verse 8.
A sada pogledajmo osmi stih.
This is a faithful saying, and these things I want you to affirm constantly, that those who have believed in God should be careful to maintain good works. These things are good and profitable to mankind.
Istinita je reč, i u ovome hoću da utvrđuješ, da se oni koji verovaše Bogu trude i staraju za dobro delo, ovo je korisno ljudima i dobro.
Now, let me make it very clear. These good works are not for our benefit, but for the benefit of the world.
Da budemo sasvim jasni, ova dobra dela nisu na našu korist, nego na korist drugih.
So genuine justification by faith always produces works.
Dakle, iskreno opravdanje ili pravo opravdanje verom uvek donosi ili proizvodi dobro delo.
Let's go to the judgment.
Vratimo se na sud.
Your name comes up.
Pojavljuje se ili dolazi na red vaše ime.
And Satan is accusing you.
Satana vas optužuje.
Now, I don't know whether he goes physically to heaven to accuse you.
Ne znam da li ide fizički na nebo da bi vas optužio.
We are living in a computer age.
Mi živimo u doba kompjutera.
Every day.
Svakoga dana.
The pastor will confirm this.
I pastor može to da
every day
svakoga dana
I've been talking to my wife.
Ja razgovaram sa svojom ženom
through email.
Preko emaila.
Because I don't have to go physically to America to talk to her. I can talk to her from here.
Ne moram da idem fizički u Ameriku da bih s njom razgovarao, mogu odavde s njom.
So I don't know what kind of email the devil is using.
Ne znam kakav email koristi đavo.
But he's accusing us that we are sinners.
Ali nas on optužuje da smo grešnici.
Just like he did to Moses when Christ came to take him to heaven.
Isto kao što je činio sa Mojsijem kada je Isus došao da ga odvede na nebo.
And unfortunately,
i nažalost,
this time his accusations are correct.
U ovoga puta i u ovom slučaju njegove optužbe su ispravne.
We are sinners.
Mi jesmo grešnici.
We have done many wrong things.
Mi jesmo učinili mnoge loše stvari.
And Jesus,
a Isus,
our advocate,
naš advokat,
does not deny,
ne poriče,
our failures,
naše mane, naše pogreške.
What does he do to defend us?
Šta on radi da bi nas odbranio?
He brings up our works.
On iznosi naša dela.
Not as evidence of our righteousness.
Ne kao dokaz za našu pravednost.
But as evidence of our faith.
Nego kao dokaz za našu veru.
James tells us in chapter 2.
Jakov nam kaže u drugom poglavlju.
Verse 14.
14.
Verse 16, verse 20, faith without works is what?
Vera bez dela je kakva?
Dead.
Mrtva.
Because genuine justification produces our works.
Jer pravo opravdanje proizvodi dela.
Now we must be very clear.
Moramo biti sasvim načisto.
What Jesus brings up as evidence,
ono što Isus iznosi kao dokaz,
is our works of faith.
Jesu naša dela vere.
Not our works of the law.
Ne naša dela zakona.
Do you know the difference?
Da li znate u čemu je razlika?
Outwardly,
spolja gledano,
works of faith,
vera dela vere,
and works of the law,
i dela zakona
look alike.
Izgledaju isto.
But in God's eyes they are worlds apart.
Ali u Božjim očima su kao nebo i zemlja.
Works of faith
dela vere
is the fruit of the Holy Spirit.
Jeste rod Duha Svetoga.
Works of the law
dela zakona
is what we do
jeste ono što mi činimo
in order to make it to heaven.
Da bismo stigli na nebo.
Let me put it this way.
Da to izrazim ovako.
There was no Greek word in Paul's day.
U Pavlovo vreme nije bilo grčke reči
that we have in English, maybe your language to call legalism.
Koju imamo mi sada i kažemo da je to legalizam.
There was no Greek word for legalism.
Dakle, ne postoji grčka reč, nije postojala takva za legalizam.
So when Paul condemned legalism,
dakle, kad Pavle osuđuje legalizam,
he used the phrase works of God.
On je koristio izraz dela zakona.
Let me give you two examples.
Da vam dam dva primjera.
Romans chapter 9.
Rimljanima 9. poglavlje.
We'll read verse 30, 31, 32.
Čitat ćemo 30, 31, 32.
What shall we say then?
Šta ćemo dakle reći?
That Gentiles who did not pursue righteousness have attained to righteousness, even the righteousness of faith.
Da ne znabošci koji ne tražiše pravde, dok učiše pravdu, ali pravdu od vere.
But Israel, pursuing the law of righteousness, have not attained to the law of righteousness.
A Izrael tražeći zakon pravde ne dokuči zakona pravde.
Here are the two methods of salvation we discussed, you know, earlier.
Ovde su dva metode spasenja o kojima smo već ranije govorili.
The Gentiles heard the gospel.
Neznabošci su čuli evanđelje.
They believed in Jesus Christ.
Poverovali su u Isusa Hrista.
And they were declared righteous by God.
I Bog ih je proglasio pravednim.
This is righteousness by faith.
To je opravdanje kroz veru.
But the Jew, that is Israel,
a Jevrij, to jest Izrael,
tried to attain righteousness by keeping the law.
Pokušali su da steknu, da dobiju pravednost, postignu pravednost držeći zakon.
And they failed.
I nisu uspeli.
Why?
Zašto?
That's the question of verse 32. Why?
To pitanje se postavlja u 32. stihu. Zašto?
Because they did not seek it by faith, but as it were by the works of the law.
Jer ne traži iz vere, nego iz dela zakona.
So whenever you come across that phrase, works of the law,
kad god naiđete na taj izraz dela zakona,
it's always negative.
Uvijek je negativan.
Paul is not against the law of God.
Pavle nije protiv Božeg zakona.
He's against legalism.
On je protiv legalizma.
Let me give you another text.
Da pogledamo drugi text.
And there are many of them. You can say for yourself.
Mnogo, ali možete ih sami čitati.
Galatians 2.
Galatima 2. poglavlje.
Verse 16.
16. stih.
Tell me how many times that phrase works of the law appears in this one verse.
A recite mi koliko puta se taj izraz dela zakona pojavljuje u ovom stihu.
Listen carefully.
Slušajte pažljivo.
Knowing that a man is not justified by the works of the law. Verse 16.
16.
Knowing this, that a man is not justified by the works of the law, but by faith in Jesus Christ. Even we have believed in Christ Jesus, that we might be justified by faith in Christ, and not by the works of the law. For by the works of the law, no flesh shall be justified.
Pa doznavši da se čovjek neće opravdati delima zakona, nego samo verom Isusa Hrista. I mi verovali smo Hrista radi, da se opravdamo verom Hristovom, a ne delima zakona. Jer se delima zakona nikakvo telo neće opravdati.
Three times.
Tri puta.
And Paul is very clear. By the works of the law, nobody will make it to heaven.
Pavle je veoma jasan. Delima zakona niko neće otići na nebo.
But works of faith.
Ali delo vere.
The law is written in our heart. We keep the law, but not to be saved.
Dakle, zakon je u našem srcu. Mi držimo zakon, ali ne da bismo se spasili.
But because the love of God controls us.
Je već zbog toga što nas ljubav Božja kontroliše.
And love is the fulfillment of the law.
A ljubav je ispunjenje zakona.
Now let's go back to the judgment.
Vratimo se na sud.
Satan is accusing you.
Dakle, Satan vas optužuje.
Of being a sinner.
Da ste grešnici.
Day and night.
Dan i noć.
Jesus does not deny this.
Isus to ne poriče.
But
ali,
he brings up our works of faith.
On iznosi naša dela vere.
As a witness.
Kao svedočanstvo.
As an evidence.
Kao dokaz.
Not of our righteousness.
Ne za našu pravednost.
But of our faith.
Već kao dokaz naše vere.
Faith in whom?
Vere u koga?
In Christ.
U Hrista.
And Christ says to the devil,
a Hristos kaže đavolu,
yes, this person is a sinner.
Da, ta osoba jeste grešnik.
But
ali,
he or she is resting in me for salvation.
On ili ona počiva u meni za spasenje.
So if you want to condemn this person,
ako hoćeš da osudiš tu osobu,
you have to show sin in me.
Moraš da pokažeš greh u meni.
Can he do that?
Može li on to da učini?
No.
Ne.
And so Christ says to Satan.
Zato Hristos kaže Satani.
I rebuke you.
Tebe ukoravam.
You have no claim on this person.
Nemaš pravo, ne možeš da položiš pravo na ovu osobu.
I have plucked this person out of the fire.
Ja sam izvukao ovu osobu iz ognja.
Zechariah 3.
Zaharija 3. glava.
This person belongs to me.
Ta osoba pripada meni.
And Satan.
A Satana.
Like a defeated dog.
Kao pobeđeni pas.
Puts the cheese tail between his legs and takes off.
Podvija rep između svoje noge i odlazi.
Now I'm not making this up, I'm going to show it to you.
Ja to ne izmišljam, ja ću vam to pokazati.
Please turn to chapter 2 of James.
Jakob, drugo poglavlje.
Now James is writing to the Jews of the dispersion.
Jakob piše Jevrejima u rasejanju.
And he has told them, I gave you the text, verse 14, 17 and 20, faith without works is dead.
I kao što sam kazao, u stihovima on govori da je vera bez dela mrtva.
James 2. James 2, I gave you verse 14, 17 and 20.
Dakle, 2, 14, 17 i 18.
That faith without works is dead.
Da je vera bez dela mrtva.
But now in verse 21,
a onda u 21. stihu,
James is using Abraham.
Jakub koristi Abrama,
who is the father of the Jews.
Koji je otac Hebreja.
Listen to this.
I kaže,
was not Abraham our father justified by works when he offered Isaac his son on the altar?
Abraham, otac naš, ne opravdali se delima kad prinese Isaka sina svojega na altar?
And the scripture was fulfilled. Verse 23.
I 23. stih.
And the scripture was fulfilled which says, Abraham believed God and it was accounted to him for righteousness.
Izvrši se pismo koje govori Abraham verova Bogu i primi mu se u pravdu.
And he was called the friend of God.
I prijatelj Božji nazva
se. Verse 24.
24. stih.
You see then that a man is justified by works and not by faith only.
Vidite li dakle da se delima pravda čovek a ne samom verom.
Now this seems to contradict Paul's writings.
Ovo kao da je u suprotnosti sa Pavlom.
But let's analyze it.
Pisanje. Let's analyze. Ali da analiziramo.
How old was Abraham when he offered up Isaac? How old?
Koliko je godina bilo Abramu kada je prineo Isak?
Approximately.
Otprilike.
between 117 and 120. We don't know the exact.
Ne znamo tačno, ali otprilike 117, 120.
How old was Abraham when God justified him by faith?
Koliko je godina bilo Abrahamu kada ga je opravdao verom? Kada je poverovao?
Yeah, Isaac was not born, yes, long before Isaac was born.
Davno pre nego što je Isaac bio rođen. Chapter 15 of Genesis.
He was 85, thank you.
Bilo mu je 85 godina.
So he was justified by faith long before he offered up Isaac.
Dakle, bio je opravdan verom davno pre nego što je primio Isaka.
Now you remember the story I told you about Abraham.
Da li se sjećate priče koju sam vam ispričao o Abramu?
From the time God promised Abraham a son.
Od vremena kada je Bog obećao Abramu sina.
To the time he gave him that son.
Do vremena kada mu je dao sina.
Was 25 years.
Prošlo je 25 godina.
One year before Isaac was born.
Godinu dana pre nego što je Isak rođen.
Sarah had passed the age of childbearing.
Sari je bilo prošlo vreme za rađanje djece.
God said to Abraham.
Bog je kazao Abramu.
Do you believe I can still keep my promise?
Da li veruješ da ja još uvek mogu da održim svoje obećanje?
And Abraham said, yes, God, you can do the impossible.
A Abram je kazao, da Bože, ti možeš učiniti i nemoguće.
And God said, I'm tired of your faith going up and down.
I Bog je kazao, umoran sam već od toga da tvoja vera ide gore dole.
I want it to see your faith.
Ja želim da vidim tvoju
so that,
da zapečatim tvoju veru.
So that it becomes unshakable.
Da postane nepokolebljiva.
What was the sign of the seal?
Koji je bio znak tog pečata?
Circumcision.
Obrezanje.
Romans 4 verse 11.
Rimljanima 4.11.
His faith was now sealed.
Dakle, njegova vera je sada bila zapečaćena.
70 to 20 years later, after Isaac was born.
17 do 20 godina nakon Isakovog rođenja.
God tested that faith.
Bog je iskušao tu veru.
It was a terrible test.
Bilo je to strašno iskušenje.
It's found in Hebrews 11.
Nalazimo u Jevrejima 11. stihu.
Verse 17.
11. poglavlju.
Keep your finger on James 2.
Držite prst svoj na Jakovljevu poslanicu.
Hebrews chapter 11.
Jevrejima 11. poglavlje.
Verse 17.
17. stih.
By faith, Abraham, when he was tested, offered up Isaac, and he who had received the promise offered up his only begotten son.
Verom primete Abram Isaka kad bi kušan, i jedinorodno ga prinošeše, pošto veše primio obećanje.
Of whom it was said, in Isaac your seed shall be called.
U kojemu beše kazano, u Isaku nazvat će ti se seme.
Accounting that God was able to raise him up even from the dead, from which he also received him in a figurative sense.
Pomislivši da je Bog kadar i iz mrtvih vaskrsnuti, zato ga se zaprili.
God comes to Abraham
Bog dolazi Abramu
and says to him,
i kaže mu,
take this special son of yours,
uzmi tvog dragog sina,
through whom I have promised the Messiah,
preko koga sam ti obećao Mesiju,
and kill him,
i ubi ga,
sacrifice him to me,
prinesi ga meni na žrtvu.
And Abraham could have said to God,
Abraham je mogao da kaže Bogu,
if I kill him, where will the Messiah come from?
Ako ga ubijem, odakle će doći Mesija?
But Abraham did not say that.
Ali Abram to nije kazao.
He said, God,
on je kazao,
Bože, I have learned one thing.
Naučio sam jednu
that
stvar.
That when you make a promise, you keep it.
Da kad ti daš obećanje, ti održiš.
If you want me to kill him, I will kill him.
Ako ti želiš da ga ja ubijem, ubit ću
ga. But I know you will do what?
Ali ja znam da ćeš ti, da ćeš ga ti vaskrsnuti.
So when he lifted up that knife,
i kada je podigao nož,
was it a work of law or was it a work of faith?
Da li je to bilo delo zakona ili delo vere?
Work of faith.
To je bilo delo
vere. Go back to James 2.
Vratimo se na Jakov.
You will notice there is one verse I did not read.
Vi znate da postoji jedan stih koji ja nisam pročitao.
Verse 22.
22. stih.
Because James and Paul are not in disagreement.
Jer Jakov i Pavle nisu u neslaganju, u sukobu.
They both believe in works of faith.
Obojica veruju u dela vere.
Look at verse 22.
Pogledajmo 22. stih.
Do you see that faith was working together with his works, and by works faith was made perfect?
Vidiš li da vera pomaže delima njegovim i kroz dela savrši se vera?
Please notice, it wasn't the righteousness of Abel that was made perfect, his faith was made perfect.
Zapazimo da nije pravednost učinila Avrama savršenim, nego vera.
So what James is saying in verse 24, genuine justification by faith always produces works.
Zato u 24. stihu kaže pravo opravdanje verom donosi uvek dela.
So faith is more than crying out, pray the Lord, I'm saved. Faith is more than saying people, I'm saved by faith.
Dakle, vera je mnogo više nego kad kažemo ja sam spašen verom.
Faith is saying not I, but Christ.
Vera kaže ne ja, ne Kristus.
And Christ will produce good works.
A Kristus stvara u nama proizvodi.
You may not be aware of them.
Možda nismo svesni tih dela.
But God is aware of them.
Ali Bog je njih svestan.
And in the judgment.
I onda na sudu.
If you are resting in Christ alone.
Ako samo u Hristu
počivamo. And have obeyed the gospel from the heart.
I ako smo poslušali evanđelje od srca.
Jesus.
Isus.
Will defend you.
Će nas odbraniti.
And he will win the case.
I on će pobediti, dobit će slučaj.
He will vindicate the believers.
On će odbraniti vernike.
Because Hebrews 7 verse 25 says he is able to save us to the very end.
Jer u Jevrejima in Hebrews 7
verse 25.
25. stih kaže kadar je spasti nas do kraja.
And when he has finished this judgment,
i kada završi taj sud,
he'll come
on
back
će doći,
to take
vratiti se da nas odvede kući.
And what will he say to us?
I šta će nam reći?
Come.
Dođi.
Inherit the kingdom.
Nasledi carstvo.
Prepared for you.
Pripravljeno za tebe.
From when?
Od kada?
Foundation of the world.
Od postanja sveta.
Our performance had nothing to do with it.
Ono što smo mi učinili nema nikakve veze.
So my dear people.
Zato dragi moji.
Now.
Sada.
I no longer pray like I used to.
Neću se više moliti kao što sam se molio.
I used to pray like this.
Molio sam se ovako.
Please don't bring my name up as yet.
Nemoj još iznositi moje ime.
I'm not yet ready.
Još nisam.
No longer.
Spreman. Više se ne molim.
You know what my prayer is today?
Znate kako se
please
danas
molim? Bring my name quickly.
Molim te, neka se moje ime brzo pojavi.
I want you to shut the mouth of the accuser.
I ja želim da zatvoriš usta tužioca.
So the judgment is good news.
Dakle, sud je radosna vest.
For the believers.
Za vernike. Za ono da koji
at last.
Jer konačno.
The enemy of souls will be defeated.
Jer će konačno neprijatelj duša biti poražen.
In the judgment.
Na sudu.
That is the kind of Savior we have.
Eto takvog spasitelja mi imamo.
He redeemed us.
On nas je otkupio.
2000 years ago.
Pre oko 2000 godina.
Now he is in the right hand of God.
Sada je sa desne strane Bogu.
As our high priest.
Kao naš prvosveštenik.
Interceding for us.
posredujući za nas.
No retirement.
Nema odmora.
Until he puts all enemies under his
foot. Sve dok sve svoje neprijatelje ne položi pod noge svoje.
So stop being worried about the judgment.
Zato nemojte više brinuti o sudu.
It is good news.
To je radosna vest.
Because Jesus will vindicate us.
Jer će nas Isus odbraniti.
I can go home rejoicing.
Dakle, radosna srca možete otići kući.
God bless you.
Bog vas blagoslovi.
Let us pray.
Pomolit ćemo se.
Thank you, Lord.
Hvala ti, Gospode.
For such a wonderful Savior.
Što imamo tako divnog spasitelja.
Not only was he willing to come to this earth.
Ne samo što je bio voljan da dođe na ovu zemlju.
Not only was he willing to join himself to us sinners.
Ne samo što je bio voljan da se da dođe kod grešnika.
But we thank you.
Nego ti zahvaljujemo.
That by his life and death.
Što njegovim životom i smrću
he redeemed us fully and completely from the sin problem.
Što nas je spasio potpuno i sasvim od problema greha.
And we thank you now that he is at your right hand.
I zahvaljujemo ti što je sada tebi s desne strane.
To represent us.
Da nas predstavlja.
And we thank you.
I zahvaljujemo ti
that he is able to save us to the uttermost.
Što nas može spasti potpuno.
Because we come to you in his precious name.
Jer mi k tebi dolazimo u njegovo dragoceno ime.
Amen.
Amen.
Well, God bless you.
Neka vas Bog blagoslovi.
Tomorrow.